This is Dane Wigington with geoengineeringwatch.org. Many people have felt how warm the sun feels on their face, and some think it's their imagination, but it's not. The ozone layer is being torn to shreds. Climate engineering appears to be a primary causal factor, not the only factor, but a primary factor. So today I want to show UV meters that show how high the UVB is specifically. We're told that by all major agencies, WHO, the World Health Organization, NOAA, National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration, we're told by all major organizations that no more than 5% of all incoming UV should be UVB. But we're metering this, and we know that that's a lie. In fact, we are seeing UVB levels that are 50 to 60% of incoming UV. That means the UVB is about 1,000% of what we're being told. So let's take a look at the meter and prove that this is actually the UV levels, UVB specifically, are off the charts. So how we do that is we have separate meters. We have about $1,000 Omega meter here, which measures UVA and UVC. So if you turn the sensor toward the sun and you get the highest possible reading, it looks like we're somewhere in the range of 4.31, 4.32 milliwatts per centimeter squared. So that's our UVA measurement. Now we're going to measure UVA and UVB, and we'll subtract the UVA measurement from that total. So with another meter, so we'll turn the sensor again toward the sun. This measurement you see here is a combination of UVA and UVB combined. So if we try to get the sensor directly toward the sun, we're getting something about 10.5 milliwatts per centimeter squared. It's measured in the same increment as the other meter. So if we have 10.5 milliwatts per centimeter squared and we subtract the UVA, which I believe was 4.3 milliwatts per centimeter squared, we end up with about 60% of the total incoming UV is UVB. And that's simply off the charts. Federal agencies are not telling us about this issue. They're not informing us. We can see the bark is being burned off of trees in many locations around the globe. Trees are dropping branches, which means you have a lot of dead branches with those trees. A lot of foliage dropping is occurring. We see plankton die off because the UVB is so intense. We have peer-reviewed study of whales' backs being sunburnt, fish backs being sunburnt, reefs being sun-scorched. The UVB issue is a very dire issue, and it's imperative that we bring this issue to light so that agencies are forced to disclose this. It's a very serious human health issue. It's very serious for optical damage to the human body. Again, the agencies appear to be basically putting out a fictitious UV reading. It's all collected by a central data collecting center, and the reading they put out on a simple scale of 1 to 15 simply isn't related to any actual measurements. So it's imperative, again, that people understand the sun feels hot on your skin, feels warm and intense because it is. We're seeing astoundingly high UV readings, and we know that climate engineering decimates the ozone layer. I challenge anybody to Google geoengineering destroys the ozone layer or geoengineering damages ozone layer. You'll find a mountain of data from a lot of sources. So please help us sound the alarm. This is Dane Wigington with geoengineeringwatch.org.